warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning. My name is Zaid and I'm a representative of the Sultan Bao Center. Jazakallah for your participation, for sacrificing
your time to be with us today. I am here to talk about what ordinary people like you and I can do to fight against environmental issues such as pollution and water wastage.
Why? Because we are running out of time to act. On the last Saturday of March every year at 8:30 p.m., over 180 countries around the globe commemorate an international lights out event known as Earth Hour.
It is a global initiative that aims to tackle environmental issues and our nature crisis, the worst of which our children or grandchildren may have to be. It is only a matter of time. One of the main objectives of Earth Hour is to create awareness for saving the Earth.
Not only during that hour, but also how we can make simple changes in our daily lives that collectively, over time, could have a strong impact on helping the environment and saving our planet.
Many people who take part in Earth Hour feel inspired to do more to protect the planet. That is what we are doing, bringing people together to make us aware of the severity of the problem and to show us that a better and cleaner world is possible. Today you are part of the change and the solution.
By keeping our community clean and by planting trees in and around the area. The COVID-19 pandemic has taught us the importance of togetherness and supporting one another. And as we emerge from this challenging health, social and economic crisis, it is important that we continue to work together to face the planet's environmental challenges as well.
Our Earth is a blue planet, with more than 70% of the Earth's surface covered in water. We have around 326 million trillion gallons of water on this planet, but 97% is salty, 2% is frozen, and only 1% is liquid fresh water. That 1%, my dear friends, is what we live off.
Most of that 1% is underground and expensive to get to. Boreholes cost over 100,000 rand. Just to access water underground. With issues like climate change and water wastage around the world, availability of water is becoming more scarce. Investment banking group Goldman Sachs predicts that water will be the petroleum of the next century. One of the biggest issues we face as South Africans is water wastage and misuse of water around our major cities.
Did you know that the average South African uses 237 liters of water daily, which is 64 liters more than the average around the world? This is a poor reflection on our country, as South Africa is the 39th driest country in the world. All of us at some point in our lives have noticed a burst pipe, a leaking tap, or stolen water meters, whether in our homes or in public areas.
A leading water researcher said that South Africa loses more than 230 million liters of water every day around the country. Let's use Cape Town as an example. In 2014, before the drought and water crisis, the Western Cape's daily water use was around 1.2 billion liters per day. In fear of reaching day zero, the citizens of Cape Town made simple yet effective changes in their homes and daily lives that collectively reduced the usage to only 516 million litres per day by 2018.
That's a decrease of more than 50% in just 4 years. Now you see, the trick about water conservation is to recognize how valuable it really is before we lose what we have left of that 1%. And remembering that our fate is tied to a very basic need that runs out of our taps. Only with the threat of losing that water do we truly understand how crucial it is to our survival. But there are many ways we as South Africans can save water.
1. Meter readings should be checked regularly to ensure that any leaks are quickly detected and repaired. 2. Use a catch bucket to collect shower water as it runs and reuse it. 3. Now that autumn approaches, sweep away leaves and debris rather than using a hose to spray them away. 4. Did you know that if you turn off the tap while brushing your teeth, you can save 9 liters of water? 5. Did you know that you can make full wudu using just 1 cup of water?
But that's just water. What about pollution? Let me paint a picture for you. You are sitting with your family in the car, taking a relaxing Sunday afternoon drive along the highway,
eating an ice cream cone or a perfectly swirled Oreo McFlurry. But there's something that seems to be spoiling your Sunday drive view. You just can't figure out what it is. Maybe it's your windscreen, but using your window wipers seem to be of no help. You still notice this brown haziness hanging over the beautiful city skyline that you see in the distance. That, my friends, is smog. A thick, dangerous, toxic blanket of smoke and fog that affects our lungs and breathing.
This is caused by air pollution and is extremely dangerous to our health. Did you know that in Durban South, poorer children who live and go to schools near the city's refineries have the world's highest rates of asthma? In Johannesburg, Soweto was built near the city's mine dumps and its residents breathe in the toxic dust. Air pollution is one of the leading causes of asthma in South Africa. And when it comes to reported asthma deaths, South Africa is in the 4th place worldwide.
According to the South African Medical Journal, between 6 to 10% of adults have asthma, and living in highly polluted areas also increases the severity of wheezing in young children. Look, I can stand here for hours, if not days, giving you facts and figures about water wastage or air pollution and how it will affect us and our future generations. But it will mean nothing if we don't do anything about it.
Robert Swan, an explorer, said, "The greatest threat to our planet is thinking someone else will save it." Dear friends and family, if we don't do it, no one will. And it needs to continue long after we have passed from this world. So we must also involve the next generation in our effort to help save this planet. The World Wide Fund for Nature said, "We are the first generation to know we are destroying the world, and we could be the last to do anything about it." And today, not only here, but across the country, in various cities, our SBC teams are gathering together, just as we are right now, listening to these exact same words. You see, we don't just want to save the earth, we want to leave it in a better condition than we found it, inshallah.